revolution will not be televised. There will be no highlights of the 11 o'clock news and no pictures of Harry Ball with the richness and national nasties blowing her nose. The theme song will not be written by Jim Webb or Francis Scott Key, nor sung by Glenn Campbell, Tom Jones, Johnny Cash, Eagles, or Humperdinck on the rare earth. The revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be right back after a message about a white tornado, white lightning, or white people.
Painter. triptych. Triptych? Yeah, triptych. Well, that called for a shot. Down the hatch. What's a triptych? A triptych is three paintings that make up one work. Three paintings that make up one subject. Sort of like a new outfit. Hat, suit, and shoes.
Yeah. All right.
But the title of my triptych is Wine in the Wilderness. Three canvases on black womanhood.
Oh, they naked pictures?
No, man. All fully clothed.
Ain't nothing wrong with naked pictures, Bill. That's what you call artistic.
Look. These are all fully clothed. That could be artistic, too.
All right.
Now I call her Black Girlhood.
Oh, there's innocence, Billy boy. Don't quite know what it means. Now hold on, ain't that the little child from up the block? That called for another shot.
Hey, slow down, old time. Wait till you see this one. Look, man, there she is. Wine in the Wilderness, Mother Africa.
Oh,
regal. That's her right there.
Hot damn, no stuff. I'd die for her, Billy boy.
Hey, Omar said that a long time ago, the key to a paradise life is if a man had a loaf of bread, a jug of wine, and a woman singing to him in the wilderness.
Mm.
She is that woman. She is the bread, she is the wine, she is the singing.
Mm.
This Abyssinian maiden is paradise. Perfect black womanhood.
This here, to our business and me.
Now, she's the Congo River.
Mm.
The Sudan.
Ooh.
The Egyptian pyramids.
Oh, okay, Billy. Boy.
Her thighs are African mahogany.
Mm.
And when she speaks, her words pour forth like of the waters. Victoria Falls.
Ooh, Victoria Falls. Now that's a pretty name, Billy boy.
Victoria Falls is a waterfall, not her name. Now here's the one that really calls for the drink.
Billy boy, your picture's gone.
Not gone, man. She just hasn't been painted yet. That is the last part of my trip to.
Okay.
The unfinished third of Wine in the Wilderness. Now, she's going to be the type of chick that's grassroots. No, not grassroots, but underneath the grassroots.
Uh-huh.
The lost woman. What society has made out of our woman. She's dumb,
uh-huh.
Uneducated, a poor dumb chick that's had her behind stalked till it's numb. Uh-huh. And the sad part is, she ain't together, you know?
Sound like you told me my first wife.
The only thing she's good for is to just pass her by.
You see her coming down the block, it's in your best interest to go to the other side of the street.
Yeah. If you had to sum her up in one word, it would be nothing.
That called for a double.
Yeah, that's a double. She's the type of chick that grates on your damn nerves. And Sonny Man just called me up and told me that he found her. Running around in the middle of this riot. Sonny Man says she's the real deal from underneath them grass roots.
Okay.
A backcountry chick, straight out of the wilds of Mississippi. But she ain't even been near there. She was born in Harlem, raised right here in Harlem. But backcountry. You got the picture?
When she get here, let's me and you stomp her to death.
Not until I paint her first. I put her right here on this canvas. Yeah. Once she's put on canvas, triptych will be finished.
Triptych will be finished. Hey, triptych will be finished.
And then Wine in the Wilderness will go up on the wall and improve the view of some post office.
That'll be nice.
Or maybe a library. Maybe even a bank.
Now that there's where the money is.
And my queen, my black queen, will sit up on that wall and look down at all the messed up chicks in the neighborhood and let them know what a real woman ought to be.
Mm.
Yeah. And triptych will be complete.
Wild in the wilderness up against the wall. Wild in the wilderness up against the wall. Wild in the wilderness up against the wall. Wild in
the
wilderness. Hey, look, no, man, we just down here painting pictures.
Oh, that noise. Cut the noise.
Look, another messed up chick.
Got an idea.
We can tie this rope
hold
around
on.
This bundle.
Hold on.
Can't forget that.
I'm gonna need that for later.
We tie this rope around this right here,
right? All right.
And then we'll lower it down the air shaft window.
All right.
And then we'll tie it to this nail right here. That way, the cops come, there's no loop.
Cops come, no loop. Okay. And as we're hanging free, free and breezy in the wind. All right, I can dig it, Billy boy.
Open up, Sunday come.
Hold on, wait.
And here we come.
You didn't think the door was locked, did you?
Door not locked.
You ought to knock him out of town, pushing down people's doors.
Oh, come right on in.
Yes, sirree.
Bill, meet a friend of ours. This is Miss Tommy Fields. Tommy, meet a friend of ours. This is Bill James. Bill, Tommy.
Tommy, if I may call you that.
Oh, well, help yourself, Bill. Bill Jameson, it's my pleasure. Well, all right.
The pleasure's all mine. Another friend of ours, old Tommy.
Oh, well, nice to meet you, Mr. Tommy.
What you call him, baby?
Mr. Tommy, ain't that what you say?
No, sugar pie, that's what everybody call him.
Everybody call me that. Everybody says that. Old time.
Well, that's cute, but what's your name?
His name is, what is your name?
Dogbite. What's your name, man?
My name is Edmund L. Matthews.
Edmund L. Matthews. Well, what's the L stand for?
Lorenzo. Edmund Lorenzo Matthews.
Edmund Lorenzo Matthews?
That's what I said.
Well, nice to meet you, Mr. Matthews. Now, I'll call you old timer like the rest, but I'd like to know who I'm meeting.
Nobody called me in a long time, but thank you, Miss Tommy. Won't you have a seat?
Oh, and look at that, he's a gentleman too. Bet you could tell my feet was hurting.
Mm-hmm.
I got one corn and that's one enough. I would've tell you something too.
Oh, you rest yourself, Tommy. You did say Tommy.
I cut it to Tommy. Tommy Marie.
How about some refreshment?
Yeah, I got that.
Oh, well, don't y'all carry me too fast now.
Now, look, I got what you see right here. Some wine and a couple of cans of beer.
I'll take the wine.
Yeah, I knew it.
Well, I don't want to start nothing I can't keep up.
All right, baby, you just some wine up.
You the one got the wine, not me.
Hey, that's what this for cooking.
You get loaded while you cook?
Oh, sugar. You're just too much. Have me a good time now.
Oh, man. Ooh. Didn't I tell you, man? You know what I'm saying? You did all the elements, man.
Let's get something straight. I didn't come busting in on no party. I was asked. So if you're married, got any wives or girlfriends, I'm innocent in this thing. I don't want nobody coming to jump on and shoot at me.
No, it's just us here, baby. It's just us alone.
Yeah, I'm single, baby. Don't nobody want a poor artist.
Oh, honey, we wouldn't walk you into no jealous wife or girlfriend. You painted all these pictures?
Just about. Your health, baby. To you.
Okay, and I got one for you. Like my granddaddy used to say, to the men's collars and the ladies' skirts, may they never meet.
Not long before they do.
Niggas. Let me tell you about the niggas. Let me tell you what the niggas done.
Hey, baby, we don't use that word around here. You can speak about your people a lot better than that.
She didn't mean that. Well, what must I say?
Try Afro-American.
Well, the Afro-Americans done burnt me out.
No, they didn't.
Yes, they did. Almost burnt me out. My clothes. Everything. Up in my room, the bobbin wouldn't let me get in and get it. Everything. Nailed up, shut tight like I ain't never had it.
Shame. What a shame.
A damn shame. My shoes. A brand new pair of shoes I ain't never got to wear. And if I never move, that's the truth. Everything. Gone.
Child, well, hard luck falling just to keep on falling.
My transistor radio.
Oh, geez.
The transistor. That's gone. And in my top drawer, I had $41 in now that's a lot. Tommy always got some place to go. I ain't never been nowhere that I can't go a second time. Hey, I used to talk to this lady in Tobin. She told me that, Tommy, you need anywhere to stay, you come stay right here. And that's Park Avenue, my own private bath and TV set. But I don't want that, so I make my way down to the dress factory. You know, this my friend girl, she said, Tommy, you can come stay with me and my mama. So Tommy got a place, no sweat. Look like the Afro-Americans got you too. Breaking up, breaking down, that's all they know.
Oh, no, baby, I'm just redecorating the place.
You did all this yourself? Oh, it's gonna be wild. Brick face walls, wall to wall carpet.
She was breaking up everybody in that bar. That is all laughing. Even during a ride.
Well,
she's gassing everybody.
It ain't no use in crying about it. It's already been done. They talking about Whitey, Whitey. But look who they burnt out, me.
The brothers and sisters are tired. Weary of the endless get nowhere struggle.
I'm sitting there telling it like it is, and next thing I know, they talking about bringing me here to meet you. But you know what I say? Can't nobody pick nobody for nobody. It just don't work. And I'm standing there in a mismatched skirt and top. I just want to put my dress in the cleaner. Oh, hell. I wonder if they burnt down the cleaner. Anyway, it was all done, said and done when I went back. They went in the dress in the grocery store and took the hams out and burnt off the shells and they set fire to it. And who you think live over the grocery? Me. That fool. I don't even go to the grocery store looking like this. But wouldn't you know, this would be the time that folk got a fella they want you to meet.
Tommy, they thought I would like to paint you. That's why they brought you here.
Paint me? But for what? They even got colored folk on the TV nowadays, brushing their teeth and smoking cigarettes. Why you want to paint me?
Look, Sonny Man and Cynthia were right. I would like to paint you.
Naked? With no clothes on?
No, baby, fully clothed, just as you are.
Yeah, because wearing clothes is art too.
In the cleaner, I got a white dress with an Orleans sweater. You ought to see me in that dress. Maybe I can get it out, you know, and pose in that tomorrow.
No. I must paint you today, just as you are now, holding your brown paper bag.
Me holding the damn bag? I don't know about that. Right,
look at it like this. Tonight has been a tragedy.
It sure as hell has been.
So I must paint you tonight. Tommy, in her tragedy.
I'm tired.
Well, hell, baby, all you gotta do is sit right here and rest.
I'm hungry.
Well, while you're posing, Cynthia Kenner, run down to the house so she can fix you some eggs.
Oh, honey, that's a lovely idea.
I don't want no eggs. I'm going to get me some Chinese food.
Hey, no, I'll go. If you promise to let me paint you, I'll get you anything you want.
Anything I want? Well, how that sound? I'm warning you. I am free, single, and disengaged.
Well, this is how the program is going to go. First, I'll feed you, and then I'll paint you.
All right, I'm game. First, let's talk about this anything you want, child. I want me some foo young.
Okay, anything else, baby?
Well, since you asked, I want a half a dozen order of egg rolls. I want some short ribs. Oh, and make sure they put the soy sauce and the duck sauce and the hot sauce with it, too.
All right, look, come on, y'all. I need some strong men to help you with all this.
Oh, well, y'all better hurry up before I think it's the most stuff to go along with it. Girl, turn that off. How could I forget your name as good as you've been to me this day?
remember what the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King said? I have a dream. And I liked him saying that because ain't no true words ever been spoken. Hey, I got a dream too. My dream is that somebody would just meet me halfway. Just halfway is all I ask. Somebody that'll say it's gonna be all right when the world is mean to me. I don't have to face this world alone.
About Will. It's best to never expect anything at all.
Well, of course, Cynthia, that's the foremost rule of life. Expect nothing from nobody.
Right. Don't be too quick to put your trust in these men.
Well, you put your trust in one and got yourself a husband.
Well, yes, but what I mean is, you know, a man is a man, and Bill is also an artist, and his work comes before all else. And there are other factors.
Well, what's wrong with me?
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, yes, you do. You think I'm aiming too high looking at Bill.
Oh, no, my dear.
Well, out there in the street, in the bar, you and your husband were so sure that he'd like me, that he'd want to paint my picture.
But he does like you, and he does want to paint your picture. He's very eager to paint your picture.
Something ain't fitting right.
If you don't want to do it, just let him know, and that'll be all.
Just walk up out of here while he buying me whatever I want, get me everything I ask for, that'd be dirty. All these books.
Books.
Afro-American history? I like that. Eighth grade, Cynthia. That's all I had of school. I could remember my mama tying up her stockings with stripper rascals because we ain't have no money to afford no garters. I remember her saying, ain't nothing much here to eat. Might be some bread, some coffee, nothing much. I got me a job. I was tired of that later in school.
The matriarchal society.
What's that?
A matriarchal society is one in which women rule. The women have the power. The women lead the house.
Well, we ain't have nothing to rule over. Not a pot or a window. And my papa pick himself up and run off with some finger-popping woman, and we ain't hear nothing till 10, 12 years later when the undertaker calling my mama, talking about if she had come claiming the body. And do you know my mama went down there and claimed that body? A woman gotta claim a man, even when he dead. What's wrong with me? If it's something I can change, I'm willing to change it.
You're a fine person.
Come on, I can take it!
You're too brash. You're too used to looking out for yourself. It makes us lose our femininity. It makes us seem hard. It makes us seem very hard. We do for ourselves too much.
Well, if I don't, who gonna do for me?
Give the black man his manhood again. You have to give it back to him.
I didn't take it from him. How am I gonna give it back? Listen, you had school.
I didn't. I respect that.
Yes, I've had it. The degree in the holy. And for a time, I thought I was moving into a new world, a so-called integrated world, a place where knowledge and know-how can open all doors for you, but that's a lie. And the first thing I did when I gave up that idea was give up dating white fellows.
I ain't never had none to give up. Now, I ain't sounding on you, but white people? I don't hate them, but I don't love them. They the dullest people in the world, the way they talk. Oh, hootie hoo hoo. Give it to me straight, Cynthia. The ABCs to that bill. I like him with his black, uppity, high-handed ways. What you do to get a man you want? A social worker ought to tell you things like that.
Don't chase him.
At least don't let it look that way.
Let him pursue you.
But what if he don't? Men don't chase me much. At least not the kind I like.
Learn to listen. Stand in the background a little. Ask his opinion.
What do you think, Bill?
Oh, like the white people all hooty-hoo-hoo?
But why count on him? I'm sure there are lots of other nice guys.
You don't think he'd go for me, do you?
Perhaps you're a little too much for him.
I am his type. He'd go for me, I know it.
I think you're too good for me.
I don't want to hear that. The last man told me that was trying to get away, he's good enough for me. Look, here, take this. What we need is a little more sex appeal and a lot less cooking, washing, and ironing. And work with it. Do you have to wear this wig?
Well, I like how your hair looks, but some of them naturals I just don't like. Look like you can see linen in it and it ain't been combed in forever. And
you a Muslim.
No.
Well, I'm just sick of hair. Hair, hair, hair. What to do with it, what not to do with it. Straighten it, don't straighten it. Process it, don't process it. I'm sick of hair. Fooling with it, talking about it. That's why I wear the wig.
I'm sure your own must be nicer than that.
Well, it ought to be. I only paid $19.95 for this.
Then you ought to go back to using your own. I'll be putting some thought into it.
You're a fine person, just as you are. Soften up a little.
You might surprise yourself.
I'm listening.
Expect more. Let men open doors for you.
But what if I'm standing there and he just don't open the door?
He wants to paint you is all. He's doing a kind of mural thing, and I thought he'd enjoy painting you. I'd hate to see you expect more of the situation than what's there.
Forget it, sweetie pie. Nothing that's not supposed to go be.
And look, no more Chinese restaurant left, baby. They blew it. Gone with the revolution.
All right. Let's go, baby. Put this in. It's time for home.
The revolution is here. What you gonna do with it? You paint it.
You write it. You write it into a novel 900 pages long.
You dance it. Sing it. Down the cornfield, hear that mournful sound. Dear master, sleeping on the cold, cold ground. Now, for wine in the wilderness, my trip tick will be finished.
Wine in the wilderness, huh? Exploitation?
Up and out, up and out. Move it on, Tyler. Folks can't create a crowd.
I just got to grab my thing.
Upstairs, upstairs. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. Happy painting, y'all.
What a night,
baby.
All right, where's the fooyum? Yeah, look, they blew the restaurant, baby. All I could get was a couple of francs and this orange drink from the stand.
A frankfurter? That's what you think of me, a frankfurter?
Nothing to do with what I think. The place was cold.
This is the damn city in New York, Bill. Every hour on the street, they selling pizza by the slice, chicken by the basket, hot pastrami sandwiches, and you brought me a frankfurter?
Oh, don't break bad over something to eat. The smart set, the jet set, the beautiful people. Kings and queens eat frankfurters.
If a queen asked you to go fetch her a bucket of fooyum, you wouldn't come back with no lonely ass frankfurter.
Kill me, baby. Shoot me 6 times. You see, that's the trouble with our women. You always got your mind on food.
Is that our trouble? Well, I guess there's only one thing to do. The walk up out of here, eat the frank. You got any mustard?
Let's face it, baby. Our folks are not together. The brothers and sisters have busted up Harlem. No plane, no nothing. There's your black revolution. Heads whipped, hospitals full, and we're still in the same old bag.
Well, maybe what everybody needs is somebody like you. You know, somebody that knows things, how to get up out there and do something about it.
You still mad about that frank food?
No. I just keep seeing pictures in my room and how everything must be spoiled. Who is he? He looked like somebody I maybe seen of or even heard before. There's so many things in here like this. What's this?
That's an incense burner. Was given to me by the Chinese guy Richard Lee. He was a great guy.
Do it help you catch the number?
No, baby. I just like to burn incense sometimes.
For what?
It's because I feel like it. Baby, you ain't used to nothing.
I ain't used to burning incense for nothing.
Burning what?
That stuff.
No, wait, wait. What did you call it?
Incense.
It's not incense, baby. It's incense.
Incense. Like the scents in your head. Incense. Thank you. You a very corruptible person, ain't you?
Let's put you on canvas.
I got to eat first.
See, that's another trouble with our women. You always got to eat before you do anything else. Tommy. I bet your name Thomasina. You look like a Thomasina.
You can stand there and guess all you want to until your eyes bulge out of your head, but you
never guess my first name. You might guess the middle, never the first.
Well, tell it to me.
Well, tomorrow. My name is Tomorrow.
How's that?
Tomorrow, like yesterday and the day before. My papa named me. My mama said that he thought it had a pretty sound.
Crazy. I never met a chick named Tomorrow before.
Well, they got to calling me Tommy for short, and I stuck with that. Tomorrow Marie. Sound like a promise that'll never happen.
Yeah, that's what Shakespeare said. Tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. Tomorrow, you will be put on that canvas.
Well, what's the hurry? Rome wasn't built in a day.
Look, if I finish in time, I can enter you into an exhibition.
So that brother there, who'd you say he was again?
Never let me answer. That's Frederick Douglass. He used to be a slave, and when he escaped, he spent the rest of his life trying to make us all free. He was a great guy.
Well, thank you, Mr. Douglass. Who is this light color fellow right here?
Oh, he's white, and that's John Brown. Huh. They killed him for trying to shoot the country out of the slavery bag. He dug us, you know. John Brown said, hell no, slavery must go.
Well, I heard of him before. Some folks say he was crazy.
Well, if he was shooting at us, they wouldn't have called him a nut.
School wasn't the greatest part of my life.
Even if it was, you wouldn't have learned anything about black history. Because those books ain't filled with nothing but white. Well, all except the white ones that dug us. They not in there either. Tell me, who's Elijah Lovejoy?
Elijah Lovejoy? He got to do with the Bible.
No, another white fella. Elijah had a printing press. And the main thing he would print is slavery got to go. Well, the man moved in on him. Bust his press time after time. But he kept building it back up and doing his thing. Till one final time, they came in a mob. Burnt him to death.
Oh, that's dirty.
Mm-hmm. What about Monroe Trotter?
He was white?
No. Soul brother. Spent his whole life trying to make it all right. How about Harriet Tubman?
Oh, I heard of her. And it ain't no use in you giving me no test, Billy. There's a ton of things in this room I never even heard of or seen before. Books and pictures. Hell, how will I even know?
Read. Go to a library, bookstore, hell, ask somebody.
Okay. Well, I'm asking. Teach me things.
Why torment yourself, baby? See, that's another trouble with our women. They always want to be great brains. Leave something for a man to do.
What you think about Martin Luther King?
Great guy, but it's too late in the day for the singing and the praying.
Well, what about Malcolm X?
Great cat, but there again, where's the program?
What about Adam Powell? See, I voted for him. That's one thing about me, I vote. And maybe if we all got together and voted for the right people,
the ballot box, baby, it'll take me my whole life to straighten you on that height.
Well, I've got the time.
And you're gonna end up with a king-size headache. Look, the matriarchy gotta go. Y'all fix up them suppers, make sure your husbands are happy, raise the kids.
Well, I don't have a husband, but of course that can be fixed.
You want to know the greatest thing you can do for your people? You can sit right here and let me put you on that canvas.
Well, you know, getting married and having a family might be great for our people, but I was talking about myself a little.
Forget about yourself sometimes, sugar. On that canvas, you'll be giving and giving and giving. That's where you can do your thing best. What you stalling for?
Well, I don't want to pose in this.
Why, baby, why?
Well, I don't feel proud of myself in this.
Art, baby, we're talking art. What you want? Laces? Ribbons? False eyelash?
No, just my white dress with the Orland sweater. You ought to see me in that dress, and I got these pink linen shoes to match. Oh, hell the fire, I forgot about the shoes.
Oh, stop fighting me. Man, that's another thing about our women. They don't know how to give in. It won't hurt you. Look, are you gonna pose or are you not gonna pose? Say something!
Don't quit hollering at me! Now my mama never hollered at me. You making me nervous doing all that hollering.
I'll soon be too tired to even pick up the brush, baby.
That's a white woman. I bet you never hollered at her. And I bet she your girlfriend too. And I bet when y'all was posing and painting, she was laughing and you didn't buy her no damn Frankfurt.
Well, cut that out, baby. That's just a blonde-haired, blue-eyed chick that used to pose for me. That's not where it's at. This is the new day, Doc. Black, black, black. Black is beautiful, got it? Black is beautiful.
Well, how come is it that
feel beautiful when you talk to me.
Look, look, that's your hang-up, not mine. You're supposed to stretch forth your wings like Ethiopian. Shake off them chains that's been holding you down. Lexis, you said, let them see how beautiful you are. But you too determined not to ever be beautiful. Okay, guess that makes you Tommy.
Do you even have a girlfriend, and who is she?
Oh, no, 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 doll. Look, now I know people, but I ain't with none of that tie you up and I own you job. See, that's another thing with our women. They always want to latch on. Won't you learn how to roll with the punches? Play it by ear. Was today good? Glad. Be grateful. Because today is today. Tomorrow may never come. Look, I'm sorry, baby. I forgot your name was... You acting like I belong to you. You jealous over a picture?
Well, that's how women are. Always putting themselves up against the next and seeing how they match up.
That's human nature, baby. What you call healthy competition.
Oh, so you think she's pretty?
She was. Perhaps still is. Long, silky hair. She can sit on her hair.
Oh, can't everybody?
Oh, my goodness. Look, you got a head like a rock. And you gonna get the last word if it kills you. I bet you can knock out Muhammad Ali in the first round, then rear back and beat on your chest like Tarzan. Now I'm the greatest. What are we arguing about? Maybe tomorrow is the better time to paint the picture. But you want to freshen up? Take a bath, baby? The water's nice and hot.
No, I don't, nigga.
Was that nice? You know what? Let's just paint the picture. Or you gonna hold that back too?
I'm posing, ain't I? Shall I go on and take off the wig?
No, no, no. Keep it on. It's a part of your image. You must award for a reason.
Yes. I wear it because you and those like you prefer long, silky hair. And this is the only way I can achieve it without burning my mother, baby, brains out. Got it? Aw, hell. Now I'm soaked through. Now I ain't gonna just sit here and catch double pneumonia while you paint and holler at me.
Bitch!
You must be talking about your mama.
Shut up! Just shut up! Look, I'm sorry, all right? Don't go away mad and the rest of that jazz. Put this on, okay? I'm sorry. Hello? Hello? Survivor of Mariah speaking. Who's this? Oh, yeah, it's almost ready. I just got one more picture to paint. Man, you better have a lot of room in that art gallery for what I'm about to bring in. Man, it's gonna be packed in there. You should see the chick I got here with me. Ooh, I swear, when you see this man, she will knock his socks off. What you mean? Look, I can't tell you everything right now. I can't let it all out. But I'm telling you right now. What? Look, all I can say is that she's tomorrow. She's my tomorrow. What? Man, shut up. You don't know nothing about pain anyway. Waiting on you, baby. Anytime. What? Where's the wig?
I took it off, Bill.
Well, that is very becoming. That dress.
Well, thank you.
I don't know what to say.
It's time to paint.
It is quite late.
Well, it's all right with me if it doesn't bother you any.
Well, can you put the wig back on?
Well, you don't really like wigs, do you?
No.
So let's have things the way you'd like.
Tell me about yourself. Anything.
Well, I was born in Baltimore, Maryland, and raised here in Harlem. My favorite flower is the 4 o'clocks. It's a bush flower. My wearing flower, my corsage flower, pink roses. I was raised mostly by my mama. God rest the dead. My mama, she was an Eastern Star, and her daddy was a Mason. And the reason she was an Eastern Star was because he was a Mason. You know, any man that was a Mason, his family member could be an Eastern Star. And I had an uncle who was an Elk.
I didn't know nothing about that.
Well, of course. The only reason I knew about John Brown was because the Elks bought out his farmhouse.
The Elks bought out the John Brown farm?
Yes, where he used to
they do with him?
They built a theater in his memory and put a perpetual light up, too.
Man, I don't know. Look, tell me more about you tomorrow. I bet you go to church.
Well, not as much as I used to. Early in life, I pledged myself to the African Methodist Episcopal Church, the AME Zion Church.
AME?
Yes, African Methodist Episcopal. We split from the White Methodist Episcopal in the year 1796. In the year 1800, we built our first building. Now, how about that for history?
That right?
I'm just showing off. I taught Sunday school for 2 years, and in order to teach Sunday school, you had to know the history of the AME Zion.
I can't work like this, man. I can't paint like this.
Well, have a seat. Tell me about you.
Man, everybody in my family works for the post office. My family bought a home out in Jamaica, Long Island. Everybody on the block bought an aluminum screen door with a duck on it. Or was it a swan? I had really bad dreams. Dream like I'm suffocating. Dying of suffocation. People are standing in a weird looking art gallery. And they're looking and laughing at everything I've ever done. Work starts to fade away right before my eyes. Everything I've done, laughed away.
Oh, don't be so hard on yourself. If I was as smart as you, I'd wake up singing every morning. You know, when it thunders, that's the angels in heaven rolling their hoops and bicycle wheels. My mama told me that.
I'm glad you're here, baby. Life is deep. Your who? Amy.
Thank you.
Seems like everything I ever put my hands or mind to come out wrong. Nothing but mistakes. And they say if you don't know, you don't know. And I don't know nothing. I'm just ignorant.
Oh, hush that talk. You know lots of things. Everybody does.
Well, how's the trip to you?
See there? You know more about art than I do. What's the trip to you?
Well, I'll tell you. Now, a triptych is a work of art.
Mm-hmm.
It's three pieces to be looked at all at once.
Okay.
Now, this first one here is called The Sweet Innocent Child.
She is sweet.
This next one is called Wide in the Wilderness. This here is the queen of the universe, the finest woman in the whole wide world.
That's not me.
Oh, I know, babe. You just last one back here. Now, this right here is going to be the ugly chick, the messed up chick, the one that don't nobody want no part of, no matter what.
The messed up chick? That's why they brought me here? That's why he wanted to paint me? Say it! Say it!
No, baby, I'm lying. I'm lying. See, it's the society that messed up, baby. He didn't mean it. He couldn't mean it, baby. It's all. It's just all.
So does anybody need a ride down?
My sister. Explain to him what a triptych is, old timer.
Oh, no.
Oh, you don't have to explain it because they already know the messed up chick. How come you didn't pose for that, my sister? The messed up chick lost a house last night, all burnt out with no place to go. And you and Sunny Man gave me comfort. You took me in. Took me in?
Tommy, we didn't know.
Oh, it's all right. I was lost, but now I'm found. Oh, yeah. Blind can see.
Oh, Billy boy, you might want to get on out here.
Billy, come out here, please. Mm-hmm. Old timer just let it out about the trip tip. The rest of y'all move on.
Oh, you better not. You brought me in here. You see me out.
Tommy, let me explain it to you. Old timer.
I gotta go, Cynthia. And don't you get on him. He ain't said nothing to me that ain't so. I can't wait for people to open doors and all that other stuff you talk. Y'all a bunch of liars.
Oh, Tom.
Leave him alone, Bill.
Explain to the sister that some mistakes have been made.
Yeah, baby, mistakes were made. The mistakes were yesterday, and this is today.
And I'm tomorrow. Remember? Trouble is, I was timing to you. All of you. A fool I was to think that writers and painters knew more than me.
Don't you have any forgiveness in you? Would I be begging you if I didn't care? Can't you be generous enough to just-
Oh, look? I've been generous enough. Everybody in here know that I wasn't here all night posing for no picture, nigga.
Cut it out, all right? Look, listen, and you're not going anywhere.
Oh, you wanna bet I'm out of here.
Tommy, we knew it yesterday. I told you not to expect anything out of this arrangement.
But this is a relationship, not an arrangement.
How many times I gotta tell you? Stay out of other people's businesses. What the hell you gotta do when he gets what I want? You and old timer just a yakking and a hacking. Man, I'm not gonna kill you.
It's just me and Tommy. Clear the room.
All better not or I'll kill him. The black people this and the Afro-American that. You ain't got a use for none of us. Old timer, you ain't fool too. Before I got here, didn't even none of them know your damn name.
Sister is upset.
And you quit calling me the damn sister! If you were so about it, then why don't you say my sister? Ain't no weakness in you. Who do you think you are?
I was talking in general, my sister, about the
masses. All the damn masses! You the masses your damn self, and you don't even know it. Nigger.
All right, look, now let's get this ignorant nigger talk squared away, why don't you? You can stand some education.
You treat me like a nigga, that's what.
What is a nigga? A low-degraded person.
I didn't call you a low-degraded person.
It's any low-degraded person. Hell, I learned that from my teacher in the fifth grade.
Don't pull that crap on me. Fifth grade is a liar.
Well, look, I'm trying to tell you right here. It's right here. Webster's New World Dictionary.
Oh, I don't want to hear what no college white folks say nigga is.
I'm trying to tell you, a nigga is any low-degraded person. Right here, look. Nigger, N-I-G-G-E-R,
G-G-E-R. A Negro. A member of any dark-skinned people. Damn.
Brother Malcolm said that's what they meant. Nigger is a Negro. Negro is a nigger.
A vulgar, offensive term used in hostility or contempt. Damn. So much for my fifth grade teacher.
No, they didn't call white folk niggers. Come to think of it, you ever heard Whitey call Hitler a nigger? Now, if they dig us, then they'll call them nigger lovers. But they don't call white folk niggers.
No, they don't.
They call you nigger just dry so long and then they hate you. Yeah, I call you nigger. But I love you.
There you go! There you go!
Now is not the time to talk, darling.
You love me. That's the greatest compliment
you could- Oh, nigga, you must be catching a fever. I ain't said nothing about loving you.
You did. Yes, you did.
Well, you didn't say it to me.
Oh, Tommy!
And now is not the time to say it. I'm telling you, it's not the time. But I guess it was flipping time, so I flipped. So now it's turn the other cheek time. And if I can go through my life other cheeking white folk, then I guess y'all can be other cheek too. I don't want to do it, but I gotta thank you. Because I am leaving here with much more than I came. Tomorrow had a beautiful yesterday. Bill, I can't be somebody's by your leave and want to be a wine in the wilderness woman because I am. I can't compete with the woman that you made up and painted. The woman who can't talk back. Because I'm a wine in the wilderness woman, me, Tommy Marie, alive, kicking, cussing, fighting, and looking out for my damn self because if I don't, ain't nobody else gonna do it. And Cynthia, it don't matter if I wear the wig or if I don't. Because this hats, tops, you know, it's just access, you know, the stuff you put on with your Easter outfit, you know what I'm talking about, you know.
Accessories.
Yeah, accessories. Thank you, my sister. Accessories. Something you add or take off. The real work is going on the inside. That's mine in the wilderness. A real woman. And you better believe I'm it.
Tommy, she's not it at all, Tommy. That chick I just painted on that picture is just accessories. You are. And you, Edmund Lorenzo Matthews, the real beautiful people, Cynthia.
Oh, me?
Yeah, you, baby. You and Sonny Man don't know how beautiful you are. Sit here.
Turn on and get my picture. Get my beauty on. Sit down, baby. You better get our picture to
me. Now here's old time. The one that was here before the grants and scholarships. The schools wouldn't let in. The jobs wouldn't hire.
I'm going now.
No, look, baby, you deserve to be right in the middle. Wine in the wilderness, that's you. That nightmare I had of all my work fading away, that was a good nightmare. Because I was painting in the dark. I couldn't see. I was painting all head and no heart. I couldn't see it until you came here. Baby, you gotta let me put you down. So all those little kids in the neighborhood can see what real beautiful black people are and what they ought to be. And when they see you, they'll say, yeah, she looks like somebody I know. It's because you are somebody they know. That's it right there, wine in the wilderness.
she scorched them.
Why you put a robe on here? You never know what I'm having coming.
I'm sorry. Morning, Miss Katie.
Morning, Eugene. He ran out of here like a skinned cat. Like I ain't never seen a man in his drawers before.
I see. Because I'm happy. I sing. Because I'm free.
I'm only doing it because I don't want to see a woman your age on the street today.
His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me.
Just the same, I'm glad you decided to take off today. Them white folks been coming in since sun up by the truckloads. And them mean white folks who are out for blood.
Oh, they just as scared as you of them, Katie Jones.
Ain't no sin to be scared. Aren't you scared for Eugene?
Scared of what?
That lunch counter has been white for as long as I can remember. And them white folks aim to keep it that way.
Well, let them aim all they want. The thing that teased me, y'all, is they won't let me go march with.
Oh, Miss Love, your heart couldn't take it.
Oh, you'd be amazed if my heart still took all these years.
Where is my sports shirt? The green one.
It's in the drawer where it belongs. Now I'm ironing this here white shirt for you to wear.
A white shirt? I'm not going to a formal dance.
Well, I heard them newspaper men from all over the county be there. And if they put your picture in the paper, I want them to say, my, ain't that a nice looking neat young man?
So you ask your boss how long he'll keep me neat?
Oh, I ain't asked Sheriff Morrison nothing.
He let you off so he can nurse my wounds when I get back, huh?
Oh, boy, you ain't gonna get no wounds, and you ain't gonna get this here white shirt ruined either. What you trying to do? Y'all young folks say, chicken out.
No, I am not chickening out, but I am nervous.
I'm nervous too, for myself and you young folks. Like the mayor said on TV last night, whites and colors get along here.
So long as we stay in our respective places.
He said if we want to eat at a drugstore, we ought to build our own.
Then why don't you build a drugstore on Main Street with a lunch counter in it?
Where am I going to get the money?
And where is any colored person in this town going to get the money? And even if we did, you think they'll let us buy property, let alone build anything on Main Street?
I know, Miss Love, but nothing, Katie. And you a young child, too. You should be going out there and march with the rest of them. I'm with y'all, Eugene, in mind, if not in body. But I have children to raise, and I also have a job to think about.
What do you should think about them children's futures? Them few pennies you making ain't nothing. And if things stay the same that they are now, they'll be the same for them children, too.
Oh, I provide for my children by myself, and they love me for it. We have food on our table each and every night. Beans and greens.
Katie Jones, when's the last time y'all had steaks?
Mm-hmm. Well, at least we ain't starving.
And neither is your boss lady.
Because y'all communists.
Well, ain't that something? How come every colored person that speaks up for themselves got to be called a communist?
Mm. Oh boy, go on, you now. Go put that shirt on. And put a towel on. Comb that, do something with that head. Put a part in it or something.
Oh, Lord, gracious!
Militants. That's what she called us. Militants.
Well, what does that mean?
Bad. That's what it means. Bad folks.
Well, I sure hope you love your children, but you love Miss Comfort.
I hate that woman.
Why?
I hate all white folks, don't you?
Katie Jones, I don't hate nobody. I get disgusted with them, but I don't hate them.
Well, you're different from me.
You just look at my cornbread. Don't you dare pinch on me.
I don't want none of that white man's food. Hope you choke the hell out of him. Oh, mean bastard.
Katie Jones, I see why your boss lady calls you militant.
Well, I don't like it. Pat me on my behind like I'm a dog.
Oh, he's got that habit bad. Well, now you're going to make haste with this bread now. And don't you dare pinch off it either.
You'll turn to stone.
Yes.
You about ready, sir?
like a teenager.
Oh, I'll cop it sooner or later.
I know you'll try.
You damn right.
And that's another thing. All that swearing you've been doing lately.
Well, I got it from you and your friends. Sitting right there in my front living room under the picture of Jesus. Don't explain. You know how it sounds to me.
Why you had to bring that up at a time like this?
Well, I didn't. You brought it up, baby.
And stop calling me baby. I'm a grown man.
Well, ain't I hear you grown men calling each other baby?
Well, that's different. And stop saying ain't so much, you know better.
Well, excuse me that I'm not as educated as you, but I aren't.
Good gracious.
Come over here and let me fix your tie, boy.
My tie is all right.
It's crooked.
Just like that phony sheriff you be up at 6 in the morning cooking cornbread for.
The sheriff means well, son, in his own fashion.
That bastard is one-dimensional, all black.
And don't you let him hear you call him black.
Oh, what's he gonna do? Being with his billy club like he does everything else around here?
Got to try to understand folks like that is all.
Oh, turn the other cheek, huh?
Well, that's what the Bible says.
That's what the Bible says.
I sure wish I could go down there and march with y'all.
To eyewitness the slaughter?
Oh, you ain't the only minute to want, you know.
You work for the meanest patty in town. And to hear you say he adores the ground you walk on, now you the big militant.
Well, I just try to get along with folks is all.
You don't have to work for trash like Sheriff Morrison. You don't have to work at all. You own this house. Daddy sends you checks, which you tear up. You can get a pension if you want so stubborn. You don't have to work at your age, and you surely don't have to work for trash like Sheriff Morrison.
Well, what am I supposed to do? The minute a woman's hair turns gray, folks want her to tend to a rocking chair and wait it out. Well, not this chick here, baby. I'm staying out. I got a lot more living to do before I go to meet my man.
Listen to you.
Now, I mean it. I want to be a part of this old right thing. But no, y'all say I'm too old.
That's right. Your generation and my generation are completely contrast. We don't think alike at all. The granny shovel school is dead.
That's what calling me a Tom.
I didn't call you a Tom. But I did hear you bowing and grinning at white folks. It made me sick to my stomach.
And then put your daddy through school so he could raise you with the comfort like he's raised you. Northern comfort. But no, you won't satisfy with it. You had to come down here and free a soul, brothers, from bondage, as if we couldn't do it for ourselves. Now, you can't sit up there and tell me that your world up there was perfect, because I done been there, boy, and I done seen it. Sick to your stomach. Well, I get sick to my stomach when I go on and pick up a newspaper, turn on the television, and see how our black men have been washed down by hoes who've been bitten by dogs. I get sick to my stomach when I see how hungry some folks are. I get sick to my stomach when I see how mean this world has gotten and how disrespectful it's gotten. You sitting there looking at me like that because I shocked you. Well, you shocked me because you brought your insecure behind down here to make history in your own fashion and you done scared out your mind. Now, I had dreams when I was your age too, you know.
Times were different then.
But we know what was right and what was wrong. And we know we was a part of, for better or for worse, like a marriage. And that's why that picture of Jesus in my front room got dust on it right now. Because the harder we prayed, the harder it got.
Things to get better, you always say.
Well, let's hope it don't get no worse.
Thanks to us.
Boy, if you don't take that chip off your shoulder, I'm going to blister your behind. Get on over there and eat your breakfast.
I'm not hungry.
Well, it's getting late. So you go on out that door and see. I don't want you to be late.
I bet you want them to throw me under the jailhouse so you can talk to your boss and say, oh, well, I tried to tell you. Oh, but you
well, don't have to hit you again now, boy.
I'm sorry.
Now, I got an ace in my hole, and I ain't mad about it either. You doing all this huffing and puffing, and them white boys out to blow you down with a hard step. You going to school. Us loves you known for, I promise.
bringing him his breakfast. He said, well, bring it here. His eyes lit up when he saw your coin.
Didn't they?
He told me to go get him a quart of buttermilk out the icebox. Ooh, he started eating that bread and yelling at me.
Hurry up, gal, before I finish.
Then what happened?
Ooh, when I came back with that milk, he was half sitting and half standing at his desk,
rubbing that big old belly of his. Give me that goddamn milk. Can't you see these ulcers killing the hell out of me?
Oh, he ain't got no ulcers.
He had something all right. Ooh, then his big blue eyes got to darting at what looked to be red pools of blood.
Ooh, go on, child.
He flung that plate at me, told me to get my black ass out of his face. Told me to tell all the Negroes today is the be all, end all day.
Indeed.
Then I ran across the street with them, and there were so many white folks out there, young children, even my white folks was out there.
What were they doing there?
Just standing is all, staring and watching with rocks and sticks. They was looking towards the Morrison office. Then he came out, bent over in the middle, and belched. Ooh, I could hear clear across the street.
I've seen this before, child. Oh, I've seen it. Oh, like Fulton and his entire family went out that by that way. Oh, like Fulton, he was the last to go. He sat there and he said,
I'm dying, Auntie.
I looked at him and I said, well, you related to me in some kind of way? He laughed and the pain hit him like an axe. He said, oh,
shame me, spiritual.
Well, I told him I ain't know no spiritual. I'll be glad when you dead, you rascal, you. Oh, I'll be glad when you dead, you rascal, you. Then I asked him, how come he was dying?
He was a doctor, didn't he know?
Oh, shoot. Oh, Dr. Fulton, how come you didn't treat my husband? How come you let him die down the old alley like an animal? When I got through opening his nose, what was happening to him? He raised up real red like a sheriff, his hand outstretched towards me. He fell smack onto the ground, dead. I spit on his body. Went downstairs and cooked me a steak. Got my belongings and I left.
You didn't call the undertaker?
I left that bastard for the maggots. Degrading me and calling me a nigger. I want his auntie.
Oh, they came by to question me. I was grieved, child.
You know how the niggers is afraid of death, they said. Then they left me alone. Neighbors found him a week later, stinking to hell. But, oh, I got a great peace of mind, child. Because I'm like my grandson in my own fashion. Too old to be hitting with her. But I dub boats and does my bit.
Well, I reckon I'll get on. You gonna be all right here by yourself?
Oh, I'll be fine. You gonna tend to them churn when I get away from you now.
Ma'am.
Them churn got eyes, Katie Jones, and they ain't gonna be liking their mama's attitude much longer.
I don't know what you mean, Miss Love.
That's a shame you're gonna be a fool all your life. But it's all right, child. You'll go one day. Just hope it's not too late. You go on.
Yes.
Grandma! Grandma! They showed us today! They didn't assault you a thing! We went to Grady!
What's that mean about?
Come on. Ooh, when we got there, every white person was in that car. They was had clubs and iron pipes. There were dogs and fire trucks and hoses. When we got to the store, old man Thomas was standing in the doorway. What y'all niggas want? Service, someone said. That's when the crowd started yelling and making nasty remarks. None of us moved an inch. Then old Sheriff Moore started walking down from his office, slowly, as if he was sick.
What did he cuss no?
He swore up and down, Grandma. What y'all niggas want here? Freedom, baby. Freedom my ass, he said. Y'all better go on back where y'all came from before I go and sit the dogs on you. We ain't leaving until we've been served, I said. He looked at me in complete amazement.
Well, gone, what the end of that?
He was mad, Grandma. He said he died before he let a nigger sat where a white woman's ass has been. God is my witness, he said. May I die before I see this place integrated. And then he took out his whistle.
And then he put his two lips together. Before he built the breath to blow, he fell smack onto the ground.
He fell to the ground into a tight ball. He was just a cussing, moaning, and thrashing around.
And then the foaming at the mouth got worse. And before he could
breathe. In the excitement, all the kids just ran in the store. And then the woman behind the counter, she said, y'all can have anything y'all want. Just don't put a price on me. And while them black faces were filling that counter, someone outside yelled,
Chef Morrison is dead.
How do you know so much? You wasn't even there.
Oh, no, so I wasn't. But I seen it before. But
seen what?
Hold up, the folks' entire family went out that way.
Grandma!
Well, some of them had it easier than the most. Depending
on what?
How they love their neighbors, mainly me.
What's in that bag you're fumbling with?
Oh, it's spice, baby.
You are lying to me. What is that?
It's the spice of life.
Did you just understand, Morrison?
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet.
What did you do to